Every now and then, a special player comes along, one so talented that no guild can afford to lose them. And when the stakes are high, you can bet on one thing. Ordinary rules do not apply. The guild sharks will stop at nothing to recruit this rising star. Backstabbing, double-crossing, lying, cheating, you name it, they'll do it, for all is considered fair in the Shadow Games. In Shadow Games, up to four competing players must gather enough favour to secure the new star. Each player begins the game with a guild ledger, a hand of two cards, and one favour of each type. Team favour, union favour, and guild favour. Two favours of each type per player are placed in the middle of the table to make the reserve. The protection tokens are added to the middle of the table as well. At the start of a player's turn, they draw cards from the game deck, taking their hand to three cards. Every turn consists of two phases, first a plotting phase and then an agent phase. Players use plot and agent cards in their respective phases to bribe, steal, and earn favour. But it is not enough to simply play the cards they receive. Fortune favours the bluffers. Cards are played face down in Shadow Games, so the players can call the card anything they want. If the other players are convinced by the lie, not only will the active player claim the rewards of the card they pretended to have, but also gain a powerful bluff bonus that will accelerate their victory. Just don't get caught. If someone calls a bluff, they get to steal a vital favour. However, if they challenge and the card wasn't a bluff, then the active player steals favour from the challenger. After a card is played and the effects have been resolved, that card is placed face up onto the discard pile. Players may not look through the discard pile, however, the top card is open information to all. Players should also keep an eye on their guild ledger, as it shows how many cards of each type are in the game deck, and is an important asset in figuring out if someone is being dishonest or not. When a player ends their turn, they must draw up to two cards in their hand. The first player to begin their plotting phase with five favours of any single type signs the player and wins the game. Shadow Games is quick to play and easy to pick up, but watch out for the other players. They will make it difficult to win.